Hey guys, welcome back to another video. It is Lisette Shy here and I am back with another entrepreneur life. Today I'm going to be telling you guys why you should never... I'm going to be telling you guys why you should never, ever, 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 ever buy a vendor list. I just want a blessing me. I want your bag, your best to me. Shorty get the bread and the recipe. So first of all, if you're trying to, you know, watch this video, then you should definitely subscribe. If you like these entrepreneur life series, if you want to become an entrepreneur, if you want to learn how to start your business, grow your business, and just keep like being an entrepreneur, definitely subscribe, because I'm gonna be trying to do one of these videos every week or every 2 weeks. So yeah, make sure you go and follow my socials, which will probably be on the screen and definitely in the description box below. But yeah, let's get into it. So guys, why you should never buy a vendor list. Personally, I've never bought a vendor list. I've looked into like vendor lists and buying a vendor list, but once I've gone into it and been, I'm seeing like what they're offering, like a 20 sheet vendor list, I'm like, why am I gonna buy a vendor list when I can literally search up what I want and I can find it? You know what I mean? Obviously, everything is on AliExpress. Like, you can find anything on AliExpress, but maybe you don't want to go to AliExpress because like long shipping, I don't know. Most vendors are based abroad and not in the... I'm from the UK. A lot of vendors aren't UK based. A lot of them are in America or China, or I've seen actually some that are like in France and Spain as well. But the majority are in China for, let's say, just in general for beauty products, because I have a beauty supply, online beauty supply store. Check it out, Lisette Makeup and Beauty. The luxury online beauty supply store that you definitely need in your life. We need a an example product. Let's go with bonnets, for example. So I bought my bonnets from, I think, Alibaba. So there's AliExpress, Alibaba, they're pretty much the same thing. I bought the pink bonnets that I have from Alibaba. Now, the shipping was long. I didn't pay very much for them, I'll be so real with you guys. And the shipping was, it wasn't incredibly long, but it was a decent amount of time because it's coming from China. Like, what can you expect? As well, in this current climate that we are in, shipping is gonna take forever because of COVID. So for example, anything is on AliExpress, and you might not want to use AliExpress, but you can literally search in silk satin hair bonnets wholesale and you'll find something. So that's like, that's an example. Obviously, if you want, so I've seen like eyelash vendors. Personally, I make the lashes, so like I would never need to go to an eyelash vendor to purchase lashes. But let's just say you go, you find somebody's eyelash vendor list, and you only need one vendor. Okay, you probably don't, you probably like would want to use a few, but you don't need 20 different vendors for lashes. Like, you just don't. And more time, you're paying them, I can't lie, I've seen vendor lists of like 50 for like £170, maybe dollars. But I've seen vendor lists of like 50 vendors for £170. That is cash loss, guys. That is cash loss. Because you can go and go on Google, type in whatever you want, plus wholesale, and you'll find stuff. Because for example, my makeup brushes that I have, I didn't even get them from AliExpress, I didn't get them from Alibaba, I literally searched in the kind of brushes I wanted and then wholesale, and loads of websites came up, and then I found some that I liked and I said, like, I inquired about them. And it's really not hard at all. Like, I feel like a lot of people just use vendor lists because they are lazy. They don't want to search for the product they want. And a lot of these times, they probably aren't even the best vendors, they probably aren't even the cheapest vendors, they probably aren't even the most quality vendors, because these are just deeper. I could create a vendor list now and you guys, like, and if I sold it to you guys for £20, I'm making money because I thought in my head, let me go and type up vendors. You know, if you're paying, even if it's just £20, like even if you're paying £20 to buy a vendor list, you're losing £20 because it's not information that you can't find for free. You know, fair enough with email lists and like brand email lists, maybe influencer emails, but even, let's be real, influencers, you can go on their page and normally their email is there. Then I would understand paying for it. But when it's a vendor list and it's, everything's on Google, you don't need to buy a vendor list. Like, you're just being lazy. I know obviously people that sell vendor lists are gonna not like this video, but it's just facts. Like, fair enough if you want to be lazy and pay, but I don't see the point when you are growing your business trying to find vendors. You want to be able to put as much money into what you're buying and your marketing and everything like that, rather than paying for a vendor list that you can literally take the time out to find a vendor for yourself. Also, another thing I thought about when I was thinking about this topic is, because okay, obviously people are going to like the popular places that sell vendor lists because I guess they're certified, or you would think because they're so popular, yep, they're definitely certified. Okay, go to them, buy a vendor list. Guys, that means that everybody is using that vendor and everybody is selling the same products that you are. And the point of having a business, you know, you want, okay, not the point of having a business, but when you do have a business, you want a USP, a unique selling point. So the fact that you have a product that is literally the same as everybody else's, and obviously you market in different ways, your packaging is probably different, but the product is essentially the same. And I can't lie, people are clocking on to the fact that businesses buy from AliExpress and sell for, like, for example, an example that I saw the other day, somebody was hating on somebody, and they were like, you're buying a pack of £2 lashes from AliExpress and then selling them each for £8. And the fact that the consumers know that, obviously, that is just how business works. That is how business works. Like, you buy something for cheap and sell it for a lot more, but in order to make a profit. But the fact that the consumers know that they themselves can go to AliExpress is like, well, I can go to AliExpress and buy a pack of these lashes for £2. I can buy, let's say for example, 6 for £2. Why am I gonna go buy yours that are £8 each? Like, that doesn't make sense. And some people will, because obviously, especially if you're bait and you're an influencer, then yeah, I'm gonna buy so and so's lashes for £8 because they're this person. But obviously, if you're just like a regular person like me, then why wouldn't they go to that person that's selling the lashes for £8, even though yours might be £6 and on AliExpress it's £2, but they're all the same lashes. Like, they'll either go to one person, and most of the time the consumer will pick the cheaper option. Like, let's be honest, if I was into like 25mm lashes, and you know, I would definitely go and buy them straight off AliExpress. Yes, I have to wait longer, but it's cheaper, you know. And I obviously, there's different kinds of people in the world. Some people just don't want to wait long and, you know, would rather pay extra for like quick service or whatever, but I know people that just buy their lashes off AliExpress. Like, and that is why I initially thought, I was like, yeah, I'm not really, I don't think I'd ever sell lashes, because what's the point? Like, there's no, my consumer isn't getting no extra value that they can't get from AliExpress buying it for cheaper. That is why I make my lashes, guys. So they are all handmade, handmade luxury lashes, you know, and they're different, you know. Obviously, I guess you could find a pair that is like this, but you couldn't find this pair on AliExpress, you know what I mean? They're made with care and love, but anyways, this isn't an advertisement video. But yeah, that is just what I wanted to say. Like, don't be buying vendor lists, you're wasting vendor lists, you're wasting your money. Just go and search for yourself, like, honestly. But that is the end of the video, guys. I hope you did enjoy this video. I hope you got some value from this video. Definitely comment down below what other entrepreneur life videos you do want to see, what other things you guys want me to help you with. I might like branch this out. Obviously, they're entrepreneur life videos. I might just make business videos that are part of the entrepreneur life videos, the entrepreneur life series. Just because your girl's been learning some things, and I just want to share a lot of the things that I'm learning. And I just see a lot of these financial advisors on Twitter, and there's this one guy on TikTok, he's chatting just absolute nothingness. Like, nothingness is coming out of his mouth, and it's crazy that people are literally like, oh my gosh, financial advisor, when he's not giving anybody any like real value. But yeah, let me know what you guys want to see and I will do that for you. But yeah, thank you for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe and like, because you guys don't be liking my videos, and it's just really frustrating, and I just feel like pulling my hair out. But you know, I've grown this hair and I'm not gonna pull it out. But yeah, I will see you guys in the next video.